Amen. Good morning. So glad to see you in the house of the Lord today, in person and online. Glad that you're here to worship with us today. This is the day the Lord has made. We're already rejoicing, and I can see in your face you're glad to do it. So we're grateful for that. A couple of announcements, just to be sure you're aware of. If you are visiting with us today, especially here in person, and this is your first time, we do have a special gift for you out in our narthex. Hope you'll stop by and pick that up before you leave today. And if you're visiting with us online or in person, check us out online. Check us out on our website. Lots of information about what we're about. And we're going to hear about that all the rest of this month in the sermon series. But we're glad that you're here. Check us out. See where you can plug in, what ministries God might be calling you to. One of the ministries that we do here, which is a wonderful ministry, is our outreach into ministry into our community. We have a soup drive for our neighborhood co-op. So the next two Sundays, 17th and 24th, bring your canned soup donations. Collection cart's going to be out in the narthex the next two Sundays. Canned soup. And I say that because we do that and someone brings syrup. I'm not sure why, but we get it every time. Canned soup. That's what we need. I'm sure they'll take the syrup as well, but we want the canned soup, so bring those. Administrative Council, our next meeting's coming up Tuesday, October 26th, 7 p.m. We're going to be doing it through Zoom, so I'll be sending out that link to you. So all that are part of the leadership expected to attend that, so put that on your calendar. The church office is going to be closed tomorrow, October 11th, Columbus Day. We're work from home a lot on Mondays anyway, but we'll be back on Tuesday. If you need something, let us know. Upcoming event, we've been asking you to already put on your calendar our family events coming up soon, Family Fall Festival. Robert Vieira is our Director of Family Ministries. He's going to come up and make a special announcement about some information, things that get you to know about it a little bit more. So Robert, come share with us.
You hear me? Okay, there we go. Good morning to everyone. Please save this date. This activity is dual purpose. The first reason we're doing it, as Pastor Eddie just said, it is an outreach event. The idea is to do a community event outside. We want to be visible. There's going to be big games, activities, food, a lot of atmosphere, live music. So that's the number one. We want to be visible to the community, those that are living across the streets in our neighborhoods, let them know that we're here. While we're not 100% operating fully with the pandemic, we do want to start. And of course, the second purpose is just for us, right? To live out the body of Christ, to be together in fellowship and church. There's going to be something for everyone. There's certainly going to be some activities that are more age appropriate for depending how you wake up that morning, if you feel healthy. There's going to be some games you can do. Certainly there's going to be other things that you should just leave for the younger ones. But overall, it's going to be food, music, just fun. Just come in fellowship. We want to be able to give information to those that drive by and stop to get some food and just let them know that we're here. There's a community of faith that wants to worship with them. All right. Thank
Great.
You.
Thank you, Robert. Sunday, October 24th. That Sunday morning, the sermon series is going to be about on connection. So this is a great way for us to connect to the community. So put that on your calendar. Well, this is a wonderful day. It's not raining, and we're grateful for that. The sun is shining, and we are here to worship God because it's all about Jesus.
I'd like to invite you guys to stand. Thank you. And this is an amazing song about keeping God first place in our hearts. And I know there's a lot of things that compete for first place, but we got to remember it's all about the Lord.
Searched much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart.
Amen. Thank you. It is all about Jesus. That's why we're here. Let's turn and greet each other. Let folks know you're glad that you're worshiping here today. Glad you're with us online as well.
As you're returning to your pew, let's draw our attention to the screen, or if you're at home, to your hymnal on number 158 as we sing our opening hymn, Come Christians, Join to Sing.
Please remain standing as we affirm together our faith, what it is that we believe in as Methodists, as Christians, as followers of Christ. This is what we believe. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Amen. Please remain standing as we sing This Is What You Do. The Lord makes us come alive.
It's always like springtime with you, making all things new. Your light is breaking through the dark. This love, it is sweeter than wine, bringing joy, bringing life. Your hope is rising like the dawn. It's It's always like springtime with you, making all things new. Your light is breaking through the dark. This love, it is sweeter than wine, bringing joy, bringing life. Your hope is rising like the dawn. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. It's always like springtime with you, making all things new. Your light is breaking through the dark. This love, it is sweeter than wine, bringing joy, bringing life. Your hope is rising like the dawn. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. 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 It's a new season. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. You make me come alive. You make me come alive. You make me come alive.
Thank you. Amen. Thank you. Please be seated. Great music this morning, because that's part of worship. And that's what we are called to do, and to bring a joyful noise to the Lord. So grateful to hear your voices singing this morning. As we go to this time of prayer, I know that you have things on your heart, people on your mind, things going on in your life that God wants to hear about, wants that relationship with. And so I hope that you'll go to him in prayer. Praise him also for the joys, for the good things, for the blessings in your life. He wants to hear that too. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Spend a few moments in your quiet time with God. Then I'll lead us in our prayer together. Let us pray. Lord God, this is the day that you have made, and it's a new day, unlike any other day. Days are behind us, no days are promised in front of us. This is the day that you have made. And as we just heard, you make all things new. So Lord, renew us today. Your word tells us that with each new day comes new blessings, new chances, new opportunities to worship you and to serve you. And God, we know in our hearts, worship is not just 1 hour, one day a week. But too many of us, that's all we do. That's all we give you. Forgive us. Help us get back to the heart of worship that's all about you. And not just in our worship time on Sunday mornings together, but in our ministry times, in our serving together times, in our growing, our learning, our connecting. Help us to remember it's all about you. Or too many of us think it's all about us. It's all about me. So in this new day, help us to remember it's all about you. Forgive us for what we've made it. You know our hearts. You know where we are. You know our thoughts. We lift our concerns to you. We pray for one another in our times of need. We pray, Lord, for those that are still fighting this pandemic. Those in the hospital right now fighting COVID, fighting for their lives. We pray, God, for our own right here in our church, several names of people. So help us to remember, God, it's not about us. It's about you. And we come to rejoice this day. For your blessings are overwhelming. What a blessing it is to be able to come and freely worship you. Help us not to take that for granted. And as we do so now, and as I do so over in the chapel, I pray, God, that you are glorified in it. That you are praised and honored and lifted high. And that our praise and worship, Lord, to you allows us to go out into this world and be that bright shining light you've called each of us to be. And I pray that something in this worship service then encourages us to do that. Regardless of what the world says, regardless of what people say we should do or should be. That we are rededicating ourselves to you today. Forgive us where we have not done so. Guide us by your Spirit so the world would know that Jesus is alive. Thank you, God, for his life, his death, his resurrection, and the abundant life he gives to each of us. And all this we ask, we lift up in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior. And we pray the prayer that he taught his disciples, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Who am I that the highest dream? Who am I?
Amen. Thank you, music team. As we come to this opportunity to give back through our tithes and offerings, different ways that you give, and we are so grateful for that, that allows us to do these ministries and these outreach things. And different ways that you can give, if you're one of those put your check into church people, we have those boxes for you at the back of the sanctuary when you leave. Hope that you'll put those in there. If you need an envelope, they're out in the narthex for that purpose. You can mail in your check if you'd like to do that. You can give through your bank. You can give on our website. Click the give button in our website. You also can text Norcross First to 73256. Many different ways to give back. Let's ask God to bless these gifts. Lord, we thank you for this opportunity to give back even a small amount of how much you have blessed us. We are so grateful. I pray, Lord, that you would bless these gifts, these offerings, the givers. That you would bless these through the works of your kingdom here on earth so your gospel will spread and your kingdom will grow. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
My King, how I love your words,
my God,
my King. Your name rings on the plains like a not so distant train, and love and history are near. In the flowers that you make, the flowers that you make, because I'll never hold a picture of the whole horizon in my view, because I'll never rip the night in two. It makes me wonder, who am I? Who
my King,
your love cuts through these pages to my heart as you grieve our sins right from the start, and sacrifice and paradise are in the plans that you made, the plans that you made, because I'll never hold a picture of the whole horizon in my view, because I'll never rip the night in two. It makes me wonder, who am I? Who am I? Who am I? Great are you. Of the whole horizon in my view, because I'll never rip the night in two. It makes me wonder, who am I? Who am I? Who am I?
Amen. Thank you. What great music we have experienced today. We're very grateful. The combination of the band with the choir. Thank you, guys. It was wonderful. And Psalm 100 speaks a lot about that. That is our scripture reading for this morning. As you're able, I ask you to stand for the reading of God's Word. 100th Psalm. All five verses of it will be on the screen. If you have your Bible, I certainly encourage you to follow along. Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he that made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name. For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Please be seated. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be pleasing and acceptable to you, our Lord, our rock, and our Redeemer. God, open our hearts, open our minds, our souls, our very being, so we can hear your message, so we can be reminded of how you have created us to worship you. And we will do so as long as we have breath. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So today I'm going to start a sermon series for the rest of this month, and it's on things that we as a church say that we are. And you say it because it's all over the church. These pictures should look familiar to you. They were here before I got here. Worship, serve, grow, connect. These are the words that we're going to be looking at the next few Sundays. We're going to go with worship, grow, and then connect and serve. So that's the kind of order we're doing, because this is what we say we are. This is who we say we are. This is who you as a church have adopted these words for the purpose of saying, this is what we do, and this is who we are. So how do we do it? Are we doing it? Are these the things that we can claim our stake and stake our claim on and say, this is us? This is what we do around here. We worship, we grow, we connect, and we serve. And by we, that's all of us. Every single person. Can't say I go to that church because they do these things. I go to this church because we do these things. And at the end of this month, you're going to have an opportunity then to put what you say you do into practice. For years and years and years and years, the United Methodist Church has had a committee on nominations. And the pastor is the chairperson of that committee. The only committee in the life of the church that the pastor is the actual chairperson of that committee. And for years and years and years, we ask people to serve. And if I'm honest with you, the word isn't ask. It's beg. I shouldn't have to beg you to serve God. I shouldn't have to beg you to please consider. And I have to almost downplay it. It's no big deal. You only meet a couple times a year. It's exhausting. So if we say we do these things, and we worship, and we grow, and we connect, and we serve, I should be having to tell you, I'm sorry, that committee's full. So let's do things a little differently. And when I went off and did this sermon series, and I've been looking at these words for over 5 years now, saying, I need to do a sermon series on this. It's who we say we are. That thought came to me. And if we really do these things, then we should be serving them and want to. So the last Sunday of this month, you're going to have an opportunity to sign up. So just know that that's coming. I had one pastor say, don't tell them. They won't show up on that Sunday. Please show up on that Sunday. But all this stems from what we've been talking about and singing about all morning already. Worship, worship, worship. Worship, worship, worship. So as we start this series about this, about who we say that we are, we've got to start with acknowledging whose we are. I'm a child of God. It's what we just heard. We are God's. We are God's people. We are the sheep of his pasture. It is he that has made us. We are his. We are his people. So that tells us who we are. That tells you who you are in God. And we're made to worship. Why we're here. Why you're here on Sunday morning online. Why you are here today is to worship. And I wrote in my newsletter article, worship isn't just a 1 hour a week obligation. It's an every day, we call it a day, every moment we have breath, time to worship. How do we do so? We do so with joy. Very beginning of what we read this morning, make a joyful noise to the Lord, all of the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Do you remember when church used to start years ago when the choir did a processional? Do you remember the choir coming down the middle aisle and coming there? What a logistic nightmare for choirs. And then people put steps in? How are you supposed to sing and step and watch and walk and keep the right note? So God bless the older choirs that used to do that, and I understand why they don't do it anymore. But we are to enter his presence with singing. And I started thinking about that in a sense of worship, in a sense of when we come into his sanctuary. Okay, not too many of us come in singing. There's some bemoaning, but not a whole lot of singing. But if you came in singing, people would probably look at you funny. But I get the gist. I get the idea. It's with the first part that we said, with joyfulness. What a joy it is to be able to come in and worship God freely. Those of you that have been on foreign mission trips, you know that's not always the case. It's easy to see in the news. There are still people that have to worship on the down low. They got to hide to do it. We don't have that problem. Our problem more is we hide our joyfulness. So make a joyful noise to the Lord. They did a whole lot better job than making a joyful noise this morning, right? That was beautiful. And them doing it together and singing these things together and playing together is beautiful words to God's ears, not just ours. Worship the Lord with gladness. Are you glad to be here today? I don't even know if I want you to answer that question. I think you have to answer that question for yourself. But I hope the answer is yes. I hope you're glad to be here. I hope that you've done these things that we just read in this 100th Psalm. Acknowledging who God is helps us to worship him. Regardless of where you are. And I looked up some synonyms for worship. Adoration. Respect. Love. So if we say that we are lovers of God, if we're saying we are his people and we love God, then we make a joyful, loving noise to the Lord. We worship, we adore, we respect, we love the Lord with gladness. Does that describe how you worship him? Now just imagine if that was your view, worshiping God. Quite impressive. But that's pretty impressive too. To be reminded of why we worship. To be reminded that it is all about Jesus. And I think it's okay for us to say, I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it. When it's all about you. So acknowledging God as our God helps us to worshiping him. And we're going to look at these words a little bit closer in just a few minutes. The scripture itself, though, gives us that sense of what we're doing, how we enter into his gates, how we enter into his courts. So that's a little bit about our attitude. And I don't know how you drove up here today, how you got here today. I came in from a different way, My oldest daughter, Jordan, has been visiting for a few weeks, and I had to get her to the airport this morning, and I came up the other way up Buford Highway. I think there's 17 lights between there and here, and I hit 15 red ones. The last two were right before you got to Beaveroo and were green. So I had a few opportunities to worship God during that time, and I missed it. And I think God made me stop all those times in preparation for how I was going to enter. Because I was running late. I needed to hurry and get here. I needed to get here and look over this and be sure we were all together and what we're doing. So I entered in a little differently. And you've heard me say in a prayer or four, help us, God, to leave maybe differently than we came in. That's pretty important too. Something in this worship service, God, let it feed us, let it fill us, let it give us what we need. And maybe we came in this morning heavy burdened and laden. Maybe we came in this morning after a tough, hard week. Maybe yesterday was a bad day for us. But yet, how we enter into his courts is important to God. We are to do so with giving thanks to him and blessing his name. So regardless of what's happened, regardless of how our week has been, regardless of what's going on in the world, we're here to do one thing. And that one thing is to worship God. Us worship him. We come a lot saying, God, what are you going to do for me today? What are you going to give me today, God? I'm here. I don't know that's all bad. I mean, we need God to fill us back up, but ask not what your church can do for you. What can you do for your church? Ask not what, God, what are you going to do for me today? God, what can I do for you today? Attitude. Worship style and space and times have certainly changed through the years. We do it a lot of different ways than we've ever done so in the past, and worship spaces have changed, and times to worship are different when we do it corporately, when we do it together. And when we have something like a COVID pandemic come up and shut down in-person worship, you got to do things different. Just have to. And it's hard to look at the whole COVID time and do what Scripture says, rejoice in the Lord always, no matter what. But I found in that COVID time of worship, when there was nobody in here for the worship time but Gary and I, our sound guy. If y'all don't know Gary, get to know him. It was different. And to worship God with nothing but a camera and a cameraman in front of me and lights set up, because we had to do it differently. I won't ever forget that. It changed. It made us do things a little bit differently. So how we worship God is important. Where and when? Every day. Go to your closet. Get on your knees. Worship God. Adore God. Respect God. Love God. For the Lord is good, his steadfast love endures forever, his faithfulness to all generations. None of us should say, why do we need to worship God? That should be pretty obvious. And it tells us worship is a lifestyle. And it's a daily choice. And how we worship him is so important. And that song, come back to the heart of worship. The heart of worship, where it's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to that. So if we look at the COVID time when we had to be out, we've come back to doing that. COVID's still around. We're still having to adjust. We're still having to do things differently. But us being here, being online, us being in worship together, that's what God wants. And that's who we are. Because it's not about us. And I don't know when that changed. And I don't know why all of a sudden church people started thinking church is all about me. But if we're truly coming back to the heart of worship, We need to change. I don't know what that means for you. You may be sitting there going, I don't have a problem. You probably don't. But church numbers pre-COVID around the world, well, mostly in America, were going down. COVID wasn't even a thing yet. So we can easily sit there and blame that's the reason. In our United Methodist Church, we have a split coming over homosexuality issues. The church was starting to go down before that was an issue. And I think it's because we're not doing that. We're not making sure it's all about Jesus. We come in thinking it's all about me, what I like. That's got to change. This attitude, coming into his gates with thanksgiving. We should be thankful to be here, not find some reason to complain. We should enter his courts with praise to God. Not bemoaning what's not going on. And then what can we do to make it better? The music today is absolutely beautiful. It's actually beautiful every Sunday. And I hope that the songs that they sang, the words that you saw, whether it's your style or not, you saw them, you read them, you understood them. Because every one of those songs were all about Jesus. Not about me, not about you so much, but about Jesus. And if we say we are a church that worships and grows and connects and serves, then we have to do so in how we worship and how we grow and how we connect and what does it mean to serve. So for 5 years, I've been working on this sermon series. 5 years. It took me 5 years to get to this point. And I think it's because I wasn't ready. I wasn't entering the courts correctly. I wasn't coming in every single workday, every single Sunday with thanksgiving. So if I'm going to ask you to change, or I'm going to ask you to maybe do something different, I have to also. The one thing that hasn't changed is the Lord is good and his steadfast love endures forever and his faithfulness to all generations. He loves his people. We are his. He is our maker. So how are we going to worship him? And I think overall, and this is probably for most people in churches, they don't think about worship again until it's next Sunday. We got to do it every day. So we don't need to try to remember what day do we worship? It's easy. Any day that ends with a Y. So let's worship and grow and connect and serve. And let's do so in a way that glorifies God, that praises him, give thanks to him, and bless his name in how we worship. And most of you, I'm pretty sure, like me, you get a song in your head and it stays there for a little while. Well, I've told you I listen to music. I love music. Friday mornings is usually my country music channel, but my 31-year-old daughter was with me and she goes, "You're listening to that again?" So I'm like, "Fine, what do you want to listen to?" 90s music. Ricky Martin song has been stuck in my head since Friday morning for some reason. But music has a way of sticking with us, and music is a big part of worship. So I hope one of these songs, and I kind of hope it's the "I'm Sorry, Lord, for the Thing I've Made It" song, where it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. Come back to that heart of worship, what it's about, who it's about. We do that, then we can do these other things that we say that we are. So worship the Lord today. And now, don't stop here in 7 minutes. The time of corporate worship will have a benediction. But your time of worship never does. Let's pray. God, you call us to worship you every day. forgive us for not doing so. You call us, God, to be your people every day, to praise you every day, not just when things are going good. So God, help us to make good on our promises to you as a church that we worship and grow and connect and serve. And help us, God, to do so every day. Forgive me, Lord, as leader, if I've not done things you've led me to do or called me to do. Forgive us as a church if we're not being the church you've called us to be. But you are such a wonderful and loving and forgiving God. And you say, here's another day. So as long as that day ends with a Y, we are going to worship you. Thank you, God, for this time to be able to do it together. May it feed us as we go out into the world. To feed others, to worship you every day. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
As we close, let's stand together singing our closing hymn, We Gather Together.
Free to worship him every single day. So go from this place of corporate worship, together worship, and go worship the Lord. Go in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, and be his. Go in Christ's name. Amen.